Dr.
وعليكم
Zaki
السلام
Naik.
ورحمة الله وبركاته.
The question is, at the moment, there have been some very bad acts supposedly done by Muslims in London. But what is the difference? There is a difference, but what is the difference that the Palestinians and the Kashmiris and Chechens are doing fighting for their freedom? Is there a difference? And I believe that there is a difference, that they are fighting for their freedom. And can you please tell me if there is a difference in what they are doing?
Let me ask the question regarding my comments on the London bomb blast that took place last month. Is it right or what happened in Chechnya, Kashmir, etc.? What happened in London last month, where more than 50 innocent human beings were killed, it's an act which is wrong. It's not allowed in Islam. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 32, if anyone kills any human being, whether Muslim or non-Muslim, unless it be for murder, or for creating corruption in the land, it is as though he has killed the whole of humanity. So if anyone kills any human being, whether it be a Christian, Jew, Hindu, or a Muslim, unless it be for murder or for creating corruption in the land, it is as though he has killed the whole of humanity. And if anyone saves any other human being, it is as though he has saved the whole of humanity. So based on this verse of the Quran, killing innocent human being is wrong. It should be condemned. But what we should note is that unfortunately the international media has got double standards. We as Muslims, we have to condemn what happened in London, bomb blast, what happened in New York on 11th of September. But we also have to condemn what happened in Afghanistan. Thousands of Afghanis were killed. What happened in Iraq? Thousands of them are killed. Unfortunately, the international media, they have got double standards. If about 50 people, more than 50 people have died in London, and we condemn it, there are thousands of people who have been killed in Afghanistan and Iraq. We have to condemn that too. Unfortunately, the Muslim Ummah, there are some people who totally condemn it and say nothing else. Some Muslims who condone it say it is right. What we should be in the middle path. While condemning it, we should also condemn the other atrocities done on the other human beings. What happened in Gujarat just a couple of years back? There were more Muslims killed in Gujarat than the human beings that were killed in the WTC, 11th of September. There was more loss in terms of property and in terms of money in Gujarat than in World Trade Center. There were thousands of Muslim women who were raped. The Indian media, alhamdulillah, did cover it, but the international media hardly spoke about it. The BBC, the CNN hardly gave few news, just a few times. But what happened in New York, it's yet shown on the television. They give publicity to it. If a few Americans are killed somewhere in the world, it becomes headline. Hundreds of Muslims have been killed in Palestine. Thousands have been killed in Gujarat. That doesn't come as headline. Why? So do you mean to say that the life of an American or a European is more superior than the life of a Palestinian or Iraqi? So these double standards are wrong. What's happened in London is to be condemned. In the same breath, we also have to condemn what happened in Afghanistan, what happened in Iraq. Hope that answers the question. Then we have the next call, please.
Assalamu alaikum.
Welcome. Assalamu alaikum.